Hey, it's MK, and I am back with another Grateful For series for you guys. And today we are grateful for our first responders. Now, I pulled out a couple little charms that are super old from close to my heart. And I mean, like, I don't know, 2015 maybe old? I'm not sure. I also have a bunch of punched out glitter leaves, as well as these fussy cut roses that I have been dying to use up. So I decided to pull them out for this layout. I have this Heidi Swap word that says fabulous. It doesn't sing though. I wish it did. I have this tag that I tried to use in another layout a couple layouts ago. This time I'm going to try to use it. And then I have a brand new sticker pack called The Details. This is my second one of these stickers, you guys. I used up a thicker set. I'm so proud of me. Pulled into my scraps for my photo mats, and then a couple paper glazes. I apologize, I do not remember their names, but I have a gold and kind of like a frosty blue, as well as this gorgeous stencil from Scrapping Reflections. I have been dying to use this stencil, but had no clue what to use it for. I also pulled out one of these grungy papers because of the fact that I was trying to pull a Janet, and I wanted to mix up my colors, but I'm not very good at it. So this is my first attempt at mixing up my colors. And I, for one, the spatula that I grabbed was way too small for my stencil. These hearts were a lot larger than I expected them to. So I went ahead and I put down the icy blue, then I put down the gold, and now I'm trying to mix the colors together, and I can already see that the frosting or the paper glaze went underneath my stencil because I was just having too much, my spatula was too small. So while that is drying and I'm debating whether or not to even use it, I'm going to go ahead and mat my photo. I'm going to mat it two times on this white. It was white embossed, and I know you guys couldn't see the emboss, and you still can't see the emboss, but it kind of gives it a little lift. And then I'm just going to use that scrap of stripe paper that I fussy cut out the florals from. And then I have this piece of paper. I was just measuring it really quickly to see whether or not I even wanted it, but I didn't want the stripes to be too overpowering because they're not gold. Now, I brought this back in and I just didn't like it. Truth be told, the gold was the wrong color of what I wanted to use. I should have mixed it in a lot more with the blue than I did, and I didn't. So I decided to grab another piece of this same exact paper that I had. I actually have four of these. So I grabbed in another piece, and I am just going to use it as a background. I'm not going to do the mixed media at all, but I am going to take these roses and just start building up my layers. This is all that I do for the entire video, is build up layers and layers and layers from this, from these roses. Now, this is a picture of me back when I was doing my entry-level firefighting training. Yes, it was. So because we work on a mine site, pretty much everybody has to be a first responder. Now, talking with Janet, what she calls first responders and what I call first responders are completely two different things. I didn't know that, and I apologize if anybody else sees a first responder as the same as Janet. Now, her definition of a first responder is those that work in the emergency field. You know, a fireman, an EMT, a paramedic, a nurse, a doctor. Those are all first responders. For us, being in a mining town, a first responder is the first person to an accident, incident, of some sort. That is a first responder for us. And basically, because of how far and remote we are from actual doctors and hospitals and ambulances and things like that, pretty much everybody is trained as a first responder per, you know, the mining field. So if you're a miner, you've got some sort of entry level of some sort of training, whether it's firefighting or, EMT training, which is actually first responder if you're not a full-blown EMT, and things like that. And so we all kind of have this somewhat training. And in a way, I actually was an EMT basic as well as an entry-level firefighter. So I was an elf. Yay. And then my favorite was the decon, which is like, oh gosh, what is it called? I called it decon. Let me interrupt myself for a minute. My daughter is here visiting while I recorded this. I absolutely loved it. And she didn't realize she was recording. Or she didn't realize I was recording. And so she's picking things up and touching things. And now she wants to help. So I am trying to help her, or having her help me place my hearts all over the layout, which I actually enjoyed. It was kind of fun. So that's that's my oldest daughter, by the way, just here on a visit. She already left by the time I am doing this voiceover, but yes, that was super cute. And I told her I would leave a portion of it in, but where she was goofing off and, you know, sticking her head under the camera, I took out because that was unnecessary. So anywho, being like I was saying about the first responding is that, you know, I am grateful for the first responders, especially during the COVID. But the thing is that, you know, in our town, it's everybody, everybody in one way or another, in all honesty. And the article that I really wanted to scrap for this video, my father couldn't find. And so I ended up going with this photo just so I had a layout to do, to talk sappy with you guys, in all honesty. I really wanted to scrapbook my dad. He was coming home from work one time and this car caught on fire on the road out to Spring Creek. And my dad had a fire extinguisher in his truck based off of his job that he does, which he's an engineer for the hospital, or he was. He's now retired, but he was. And he pulled over and helped these guys out and was actually able to put the fire out enough to save the car, in all honesty. And, you know, there was, it was such a small town. There was an ad in the paper or an article in the paper about his heroics and all that good stuff. But like I said, being the remote town that we are and so far away from hospitals you know, the medical field, we all kind of have that training, even if it's just, you know, how to do, you know, first person CPR until, you know, the real people is what we say. Sorry if it sounds rude, but until the real people show up. There's lots of things we've got. I can't even remember what they're called. We've got the heart dealios. Oh my gosh, I don't even remember what they're called, you guys. We've got them all over the place, so that way somebody can grab them and they're idiot proof. You put them on, and if it detects a heartbeat, it won't do anything. For them. They're not defibrillators though. I know that that's not what they're called, but anyways, yeah. So it's just awesome what our town has done to help us help people, until the real people show up. And so that is what I am grateful for. And that is what I wanted to do because our town recognized that we had an issue and, started making everybody, or not making, but, having everybody involved until the doctors and nurses and paramedics and ambulances can show up. And it has saved a lot of lives, by the way. Anyways, I have just babbled through the entire thing like I always do. So be sure to go check out, Janet. I want to know exactly what she is grateful for because her idea of a first responder was completely different than my idea. And so, or than what my knowledge was. And I think that that is just absolutely fascinating and amazing. And so I cannot wait to hear her story about first responders and whatnot. So anyways, her link to her channel will be down below in the description box, just underneath this video. You might have to click an arrow or you might have to click the show more button, but it is there and I will check y'all later. Bye.